what? Pastor Bowen has flipped his lid. But I needed a visual for this one. I needed you to see. And a matter of fact, sis, in a couple minutes, I need you to understand where I'm going with this. So if you can you turn to 2 Kings? Chapter 5. 2 Kings, chapter 5. Promise I won't be in front of you for very long, but I have to tell you what thus saith the Lord. Amen? If all is found, say amen. But it has. Amen. 2 Kings chapter 5. The king of Aram had a great admiration for Naaman, the commander of his army, because through him the Lord has given Aram great victory. But though Naaman was a mighty warrior, he suffered from leprosy. You may have your seats in the house of the Lord. Allow me to say the last sentence again. But through Naaman was a mighty warrior, he suffered from leprosy. For those of you who need a title of this short sermon, I will call this one, Your Healing is Not in the Water, but it's in the Creator. I'm going to go right into it because time is already past spent. If you have never committed a sin and came short of the glory of God, then this sermon is not for you.
That's right.
If you have never faced trials and tribulation that made you feel like God has forgotten you, then this one is not for you. If you have never fussed someone out and felt ashamed, and you had to go back and say, I'm sorry, then this sermon is not for you. Before I go any further, I have to explain to you what leprosy was back then. Now, you got to understand, leprosy back then would have called you out. Amen? Leprosy was common in biblical times. The main reason why leprosy is talked about so much in the Bible is, you gotta understand, it was a graphic illustration of a sinful, destructive power. In ancient Israel, leprosy was a powerful visual lesson. It also meant that you did something wrong. Now that was the thinking at the time. What have you done that you have leprosy? You gotta stay with me. You gotta stay with me. Now, look at this. There are specific instructions about leprosy in the Bible. This is not just something talked about. There is scriptures. Leviticus 13, 2 and 3. God has given the Israelites very specific instructions on how to deal with people with leprosy or other skin infection. For those of us who have bad skin right now, back in those days, you would have been considered a leper. I need you to hold tight to that. Hold tight to that. Amen? So anyone suspected of having a disease had to go to the priest. You had to go to the priest for examination. Listen now. They didn't say you got to go to the priest for the cure. They said you got to go for an examination. The priest. Stay with me. Stay with me. Stay with me. If found to be infected, the leprous person who had the disease shall wear torn clothing.
Amen.
I'm going somewhere with this. Okay. Stay with me. Stay with me. Stay with me. Now, the torn clothing. You got to understand. The leprous person had the disease shall wear torn clothing and let their hair down. I didn't have any hair, so I couldn't let it down. He shall cover up his lips and scream out, unclean, unclean. My Lord Jesus. He shall remain unclean as long as he has the disease. He is unclean. Oh God, that word unclean. He shall live alone. Come on. Come on. I'm going somewhere. His dwelling shall be outside the camp. The leper person spiritually. Just imagine the bumps and blemishes on your skin made you to be unclean. You can't be with society. Amen? So you were an outcast. But remember, I said you went to the priest for examination. But look who is casting you out. The priest. The very same one who should be helping you. Leprosy. My Lord Jesus. Now you got to get something. Now, at the time, Aram raid, I'm going back to two, invaded the land of Israel, and among their captives was a young girl who had been given to Naaman's wife as a maid. I need to talk about that sister for a minute. Forget about your leprosy for 2 minutes. Let's talk about this sister. You got to understand she was a slave. She was kidnapped and dispossessed from Israel, and now she's serving Naaman's wife. But you gotta understand who you are. She came from Israel, the Holy Land. So sometimes your physical position and condition does not dictate what you do for the Lord. I know y'all will be mad at me because you love to be comfortable while you serve the Lord. But this sister was a slave. And she was about to do some work. She was strategically placed in Naaman's life to get him some help. Some help that the king, the same priest discarded. But this is not the only place where the priest failed somebody in this scripture. I'm coming to it. I'm going to it. So now she tells Naaman, there's a man in Israel that can cure you. So some things happen. I'm gonna get to it. Some things happen. Naaman, you got to understand something. Even though Naaman was a mighty man of valor, he had an issue. He had an issue that he couldn't fix. He had an issue nobody could fix at the time. But you gotta understand something. Naaman was the enemy of the Jews. You gotta get this. You gotta get this. Because the Lord said, this is what the Lord said. Because through him, the Lord have Aram great victory. They conquered Israel. So is there anybody in the house who don't believe the Lord is merciful to your enemies? But here comes the help from the Lord. Amen? She tells him about this help that he can get that wasn't given to him by the man of God. So, now you got to get this part. You see, now I need to talk to some real functioning lepers whose Christian walk is in progress. Like me. Functional lepers, amen? So yeah, I gotta talk to you if Adam is in your DNA. Amen. I gotta talk to you if the power of the world and the worldly influences make you vulnerable to temptation. Yeah. That's who I'm talking to. If you're definitely with the Apostle Paul, what he said in Romans 7:21, so I find this to be principle. When I want to do good, evil is right there with me. So let me talk to some real Christians today. Yeah. The Bible said he was the enemy of the Jews. He had them captured. But the same Lord that we serve that allowed us to get captured is about to help the enemy. So all you judgmental people, you know the ones that like to point fingers and the ones who like to talk about you because I'm a functional leper and the Lord is blessing me. You got to understand the Lord was blessing this man. He gave him a character. So how dare you point fingers at others? It doesn't matter if I'm a functional leper. You see it? So look, some things are going to happen here. Some things are going to happen here. Now, Naaman got a letter from his boss. You know how we like to justify folk, right? This is my friend. He's a good character. Please take care of him. So he got a letter of recommendation from his boss, the king. How many of us are functioning leper and still people would recommend us? I don't know about you, but I serve a just God. I serve a true and a living God. And even though I'm a functional leper, he still loves me.
Yeah.
Put your finger if you want to. He still loves me. But look, Naaman got down there, brought his letter real quick. Sir, the king said, you sent it to the king of Israel. Here's another man of God that failed you. So I'm telling you, even if you're a functioning leper and someone failed you, you still got to keep going. But look, he didn't even realize that because he's down there with the letter. Not knowing that that man of God up there that considered him a leper should have been the one to cure him. Should have been the one who said, by his stripes, we are healed. Yeah. But he sent him on to the king of Israel. But the king of Israel was so scared. You can't put your trust in man. The Bible said he rent his clothes. He was like, what is he doing? What is this thing that he sent to me? This leprous man, how can I cure him? But hold tight, the Lord has his plan in action. You just gotta follow the play. You gotta get in the game so you can get into the Lamb of life. That's what you gotta do. So he's down there and he ripped his clothes. Have no fear, Jesus and God is here. But look, the man of God heard, the real man of God. You see, that's what's wrong with some of us. The people that we hook up to, we got this facade that we're serving the Lord. But some of us, we don't cut the mustard. We don't cut the mustard. So when people come to you for help, you're an empty shell. He's the king of Israel. He's the king of Israel. He's supposed to know where his help come from. Remember who got them out of Egypt? I know he knows his ancestral stories. He's supposed to be a man of God connected to the power of God. But he ripped his clothes. I can't do this. But there's a man named Elijah. You see, that same Elijah, he was a functioning leper too, but here's why I say that. He was the same one who wanted to commit suicide. Anybody in here just want to throw in the towel sometimes? Sometimes you just want to quit because of what life is throwing at you. You can't take it no more. Oh God, just call me home. It's not your time. If you don't get in place in the near future, someone might just die. Somebody's depending on you to get over this thing that you're going through. You got to seek the Lord. But look, the king ripped off his clothes. He couldn't do anything. But there's a man that have an authentic relationship with God. An authentic relationship. In other words, it's not like if I ask Pastor Friend, do you know Michael Jordan? He's going to say, mm-hmm. And then I want to tell him, no, Pastor, you really don't know Michael Jordan. You know of Michael Jordan. Did you get it? Do you know President Obama? Yeah, no, you don't. You really don't. You know of him. But the ones with the authentic relationship, you got to say, look, I know a man named Jesus who died. I woke up this morning.
Exactly.
Can you prove how I woke up this morning? So why would I get into a theological debate with you? I'm just telling you, I know what I know. That Jesus died on the cross for me. That is all I know, Pastor. That's all I know. Lady Godfrey, that's all I know. Sister Regina, that's all I know, sis. I can't explain it to you. I can't tell you why. But I can tell you, I was a sinner saved by grace. You gotta understand, if y'all only knew me from way back when, you would have been like, that guy crazy. But you see, Jesus grabbed me with his hands. He had plans for me. He picked me up, he turned me around, and he placed my feet on solid ground.
You
gotta get this thing. We gotta get this thing. Elijah went to see him. I'm gonna finish real quick. You got real help coming, y'all. You just gotta hold on. You got real help on the way. Don't worry about the ones who didn't help you before. Don't worry about the ones who let you down. Don't worry about the ones who's talking about you. Just know that there's help on the way. So Elijah came. But you gotta do some things for your own help. You ain't gonna like me after this. But look. Hey, my God. Here's the things that we gotta do. The first thing he went, the king gave him all his riches to give to the man of God. Some of us, we think we can pay for salvation. Well, Pastor, I'm a devout Christian. I give to the poor. I pray daily. I hold office in the church. Me and the pastor is cool. Right? So, the Lord is supposed to do whatever. Because I asked. And because I said it. Right? By virtue of who I am. Naaman was a big man in the military. You got to understand, in the kingdom, your money worth nothing. So for those of us who live in for our money, you might just want to let it go and find another source of help. So look, Naaman went down there with all the gold and silver. He pulled up with an entourage, y'all. You know how we do it? We want to get saved with our buddies and our pals. We want to take everybody down there to see the man of God. But when sometimes all you need is just for them to pray for you from a distance. That's what's wrong with some of us. We got too much people in our lives. Can I break it down for you? The negative ones, you know, the ones that keep you bound with the same nonsense every day. Well, why are you going to church today? We got a party to go to. We got a barbecue next after this thing. We're going to eat chicken. You don't need to go to church today. You go to church every day. You got a cunt, sling little. The Lord wants your attention. Amen. And that's what's wrong with us. We want to serve the Lord with everybody else. Yeah, Brother John say amen. You jump up and say amen. You don't even know why you say it. Yeah. I don't care if y'all don't like me. I'm with my brother right now. All right. So look. He goes down there with, let me break it real quick. 750 pounds of silver.
Yeah.
150 pounds of gold. And 10 sets of clothing. For the man of God.
Yes, sir.
He's going to pay for my service. He's going to pay for my service. Some of us, we want to pay for it. Here's how we do it. We get on the TV. We don't go to church on Sunday. We stay home and we watch Billy Graham and everybody else. And then at the end of the service, he comes out with a little thing of water. Yeah. This is holy water. All you have to do is send $500 and a check, and we will send it in the mail in a plastic bag. Maybe y'all haven't seen that one. I know you've seen this one. Oh, we're in Israel right now, and if you want some holy dirt, you know, holy dirt from Israel, it'll heal you. Am I the only one who's seen this? They say send it. You go to Israel and get the dirt from where Jesus was. Jesus is not in the dirt. Are you seeing where I'm going with this thing? So why are you putting your hope in some dirt and some water? I'm about to break it down for you. I'm about to break it down for you. But Naaman went to the door, not. We got some expectation issues. Us Christians. Because we want the Lord to do it how we want him to do it. Not how what his will is concerned. Just how you want. Because I'm a devout Christian. I give to the poor and pray every day. So I'm good. You got to do it just the way I said to do it. So he goes down there, and this is what I love. Elisha sent a messenger. He said, there's a leper man at my door. Go tell him, dip in the Jordan River 7 times. Close the door. Come back inside. The Bible said before that he went down there with like 600 chariots. His posse. I'm coming for my help. And I'm bringing my boys along with me. That was supposed to intimidate the man of God. But how many times people do that? They ask you to tell me, Pastor, tell me something that nobody has ever told me before.
Yeah.
And I'll come to church. One woman told me, tell her something I've never told her before, that's never been told to her before, and she'll come to church. If you're waiting for me to tell you something to come to church, you're going to be waiting for a long, long time. You need to find Jesus on. You got to seek your own soul salvation. But look, he gets there. He gets mad. Wait a minute. Don't he know who I am?
Right.
I'm that great RN. I am pastor such and such. I am doctor such and such. Don't he know I work on the 15th floor of the Pentagon? And I work for President Obama? Doesn't he know that? Don't he know I use big words in my vocabulary like lexicon and all the others?
Right, right, right.
He didn't even come out to see me. He sends out a messenger. He should have got the picture by then, but he was too big-headed. He got too much pride. That's my other point. Your pride will stop you from your healing. Leprous man and woman, your pride will stop you from your healing. Not only your pride, but your ego. And they say only men have ego. Not true. That is a lie. We both have egos, men and women. But ours is just a little bit bigger. So Naaman got pissed off. He got angry. The Bible said he got mad. How dare he send out a messenger to meet me? I am that great man. Naaman. But he got to say something. You got to say something. Thank God. When he got the message to go dip in the Jordan River, by the way. You got to get this. The Jordan River was the most nastiest river in the area. As a matter of fact, even Naaman said, well, wait a minute. There's two other rivers. There's two other rivers. They were clean and nice and pretty people out there, rich people out there on the beach without shoes. And y'all understand what I'm saying? So why he didn't send me to dip there? We have some misconceptions that the healing is in the water. Some of you think that the healing is in the altar call. I'm going to break this one down.
Sir.
You ain't going to like me after this one, but I don't care. I'm with my brother. Look, some of us, we get that sweet feeling when the word of God and the man of God say it, it touches you. It hits you in the rib and you're like, you get all emotional. And you get up here and you're saying, well, touch me, Pastor. I want to put some holy water on me. Because you got this misconception that the healing is in the holy water. The healing is not even in the touch. It's in God. But the Lord is using whoever is up here as a vessel. You got to get this. Because today you're going to get your healing if you understand this thing. This don't have anything to do with me, Pastor. It has all to do with you and your relationship. The Bible said a broken and a contrite heart, he would not despise. So if you come up here and you think the holy oil, put the cross on my head. It's in this. Change your mind. Your healing is in God. But to get to God, you got to go to Jesus. So you gotta have an authentic relationship with Jesus. Well, let's go to the dip. And then I'll close it. He had to dip 7 times. The first one, I call it, I wonder who's watching me. Based on who I am, I'm gonna lose some cool points with this thing. This guy want me to dip in the nastiest river in the air, this dirty water. If I had leprosy before, well, now I'm catching all them other stuff. This man want me to put my leper skin. My skin is already exposed. He wants me to put this water in my skin and tell me I'm going to be healed. But first, I got to watch and see who's watching me. That's what you wait for an altar call, don't we? Who else is going up there? Oh, he looked like he got problems just like me.
Oh,
she looked like she used to live a life like me. You see what she had on? I used to wear that to church, so I'm going to go up there too. And you wait till they stand. Right there. You come on up. Your intentions are wrong to begin with. This is between you and the Lord. Don't worry about what the peanut gallery got to say. What they got to say is not important. get that out the way so you can get your healing today. Amen? Amen. Because guess what? We all sin and come short of the glory of God. Right. Amen? So the second one, I call, you gotta be kidding me. This man had me dipping in this dirty water. I'm messing up my character.
Right.
My character. Because next thing you're going to hear on CNN, the great Pastor Bowen was dipping in the Jordan River.
Yes, sir.
He's messing up my character. So, the third one is, wait a minute. Let me refrain on all the issues I had. At this point, you're thinking, my skin is so tore up. This water doesn't really matter. Some of us, our issues is so rough. I don't care who's watching.
Help us.
I don't care what you say about my characters. I'm going to Jesus. I can't have you stop my press. I'm not walking, I'm pressing. If you're in my way, I got to tell you, excuse me. I might not even tell you, excuse me. I might move you out the way.
Well,
okay. Number four is, I feel the tingling.
Oh, come on, the change. Come on.
I drop my ego. You better watch this thing. I don't care who's watching.
Mm-hmm.
I feel the tingling.
Come on.
So when they dipped me in the Jordan River, I looked, old people got the same, and it's old people. They have the same. It's not in the scripture nowhere. I look at my hands. And my hands look.
No,
I look at the front. I look at the look.
Yes, sir.
Well, I felt this little tingling, y'all.
Yes, God.
But wait a minute.
Got a hold of me.
Something.
Got a hold of me.
Whoa! I don't care who's watching. As a matter of fact, I'm going down for number four. For number five.
Yes, come on.
You see, they told me to drink this water. So let me tell you about a man named Jesus.
Yes.
Let me tell you about a man named Jesus. He told me all about myself.
Yeah.
So now I got a testimony.
Yeah.
While I'm going down for number five.
Yeah.
Number five, I call. I made it too far to turn back now.
Yeah. Wow. That's a
big deal. I'm almost there.
Hey.
I'm almost there.
If I was going to die from the dirty water, I would have dead 4 days ago.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
Yes, sir.
I would have died already. And I felt this little tingling in the left foot, and I feel like James Brown.
Jesus.
You gotta get this. I looked at my head.
Jesus. The thing's looking new. Jesus.
And my hands look new.
Yes,